وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
What should we do when we see our parents sinning? How do we maintain good treatment of them? Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen wa salatu wa salam ala abdillahi wa rasulih Nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. There is no doubt that our parents sinning does not excuse us at all from keeping excellent ties with them, being good towards them and kind towards them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in the Qur'an, وَإِن جَاهَدَاكَ عَلَىٰ أَن تُشْرِكَ بِمَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٍ فَلَا تُطِعْهُمَا وَصَاحِبْهُمَا فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعْرُوفًا. And if they strive to make a partner with me in that which you have no knowledge. So here the parents are telling their child to make a partner with Allah, the greatest sin that a person can do. فَلَا تُطِعْهُمَا, don't obey them. وَصَاحِبْهُمَا فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعْرُوفًا, and accompany them in this world in the best way. So a parent who is compelling their child, forcing their child to make a partner with Allah, still has the right of good treatment, even though they are doing that. So the parent who is sinning in general is still entitled to that good treatment. And Anas radiallahu anhu narrated that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فَقَالَ رَجُلٌ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ أَنصُرُهُ إِذَا كَانَ مَظْلُومًا أَفَرَأَيْتَ إِذَا كَانَ ظَالِمًا كَيْفَ أَنصُرُهُ قَالَ تَحْجُرُهُ أَوْ قَالَ تَمْنَعُهُ مِنَ الظُّلْمِ فَإِنَّ ذَلِكَ نَصْرُهُ. We're going to use this hadith just to highlight a particular issue. It's a hadith of Anas radiallahu anhu. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, help your brother, whether he is an oppressor or oppressed. So a man said, O Messenger of Allah, I will help him if he's oppressed. But what do you think about if he is the oppressor? How could I help a person who is an oppressor? The Prophet ﷺ said that you prevent them, or you stop them from their oppression. This is what it means to help them. So what I brought this hadith for is to show you that the way that you do birr to your parents in a situation where your parents are doing major sins is by finding a way to help them to stop. And not showing, of course, any disrespect to them at all. So you have to find a way to help them to stop. But the way you stop them might be different from the way you would stop, for example, your children. Because you have a sultan, an authority over your children. But your parents have an authority over you. And that is why we can bring in this hadith narrated by Imam Ahmad and others. مَنْ أَرَادَ أَنْ يَنْصَحَ لِي ذِي سُلْطَانِ فَلَا يُبْدِهِ عَلَانِيَةً وَلَكِنْ يَأْخُذْ بِيَدِهِ فَيَخْلُو بِهِ فَإِنْ قَبِلَ مِنْهُ فَذَاكَ وَإِلَّا كَانَ قَدْ أَدَّ الَّذِي عَلَيْهِ. Whoever wants to advise a person in authority, the sultan is a person in authority, and even though the hadith generally refers to the one who is like a governor or a ruler, the parents also have authority over their children. Don't let him do so in public, but let him take the person by the hand and be alone with them. And if the person in authority accepts this, then that's all well and good. And if not, then the person has done their duty that was for them to do. So there's no doubt that when you're advising a person in authority, and even you can apply this to your parents, what you're not going to do is treat the same way as your children. Your child, you may stop them in public and you might say to them, don't do this again. I never want to see this behavior from you. You can't talk to your parents like that. And you can't publicly give them a dressing down like that because they're sinning. Rather, what you have to do is to speak to them privately, gently, kindly. And if you do that, you have done what you have to do. You've done the best you can do. So when your parents are doing sins, major sins, serious things, what you're going to do is you're going to realize that your birr towards them part of your birr towards them is stopping them from what they're doing. But you have to do it in a way that is respectful to the authority they have over you. Taking them aside, speaking to them gently, kindly, privately. And what you'll find is that this will preserve the connection between you and your parents in a good way, as opposed to the one who does things publicly, shouts at them or complains about their parents to other people. This person is doing a major sin which might be worse than the sin that the parent is doing in the first place. So it might be a case that the cure is worse than the sickness, because it may be that the parent is doing a sin that is not as bad as uquq al-walidain, as being bad to your parents. So it's very important that the person corrects their parents in a way that is respectful of the parents' position. But ultimately, you realize that the best thing you can do for your parents when they're doing sins, particularly big sins like that, the best thing that you can do for them is to help them stop doing that sin, but in a way that's respectful and kind and appropriate to the authority that they have over you. And Allah Azza wa Jalla knows best.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.